Of beasts with quite so little hair. I'm gonna be the man. Hello, everyone. If I could just quick have your attention, I would appreciate it. Welcome, parents and friends and family, or whatever you are. Thank you for being here. We're so excited to have this opportunity together in person to celebrate young people on stage. My name is Mariana Kurtz. I'm the director of this camp. Thank you for trusting me with your children for 3 weeks. I really do appreciate it, and I hope they come back and turn out okay. This performance is sort of a devised piece that was created by your performers. We rehearsed and created these wonderful masterpieces that you're about to see, but it was mostly on them. I gave them a lot of the material. We came up with this process together, but it was up to them to perform to the ability that they wanted to, and they pushed themselves very hard. So I want you to congratulate your students on their success in their art form, but I also just wanted to take a minute to thank you as parents for who you raise your children to be. Because a couple days ago, I start out every rehearsal with a check-in. Your students might have shared that with you. And in the check-in, I would say things like, you know, what's your favorite color? Or one day we went around, what's your shoe size? Someone wanted to know everyone's shoe sizes. And one day I asked, I think it was maybe Wednesday, I said, how do you feel being a part of this group? What's one word for how you feel being a part of this camp? And your students said things like, I feel like I belong, I feel welcomed, I feel loved, I feel like I have a family. And that's not something that we could have done at this camp if your students weren't who they are. And all of your students yesterday were expressing to me how thankful they were that they found a new chosen family in these students that they didn't know when they came on the first day. So I want to thank you all for who you are and who you've made these students to be. And with that, I want you to give a huge round of applause for Revuesical the Musical. Thank you.
Jessica, what did you do? Look at this mess you made. You better clean it up, now. There's gonna be paint stuck on the carpet. Why can't you think before you do stupid things? Oh, Jess, I'm sorry. Please don't cry. I didn't mean to yell. It's just that with Mom in the hospital, I'm supposed to take care of things here, and it's hard. I'm not a grown-up, but I have to try to be, because Dad works extra hard to pay for Mom's hospital bills. But everything's going to be all right. Mom will get better and come home real soon. It'll be just like it used to be. I know it. Why don't I help you clean this up? We'll do it together. I love you, Jess. Will you give me a hug?
reasonable question, and you pretended not to hear me. That's not at all nice. I say, Mr. White Rabbit, where are you going? He won't answer me, and I do so want to know what he's late for. I wonder if I might follow him. Why not? There's no rule that I may go where I please. I will follow him. Wait for me, Mr. White Rabbit. I'm coming too. How curious. I never realized that rabbit holes were so dark and so long and so empty. I believe I've been following for 5 minutes and I still cannot see the bottom. After such a fall as this, I shall think nothing of tumbling downstairs. How brave they'll all think of me at home. Why, I wouldn't say anything about it, even if I fell off the top of the house. I wonder how many miles I've fallen by this time. I must be heading somewhere near the center of the earth. I wonder if I shall fall right through the earth. How funny that would be. Oh, I think I see the bottom. Yes, I'm sure I see the bottom. I shall hit the bottom. Hit it very hard. And oh, how it will hurt.
We're two of a kind, all right? Partners?
Through thick or thin,
night or day,
right or wrong,
if you're ever in a jam, here I am.
If you ever need a pal on your gal,
if you ever feel so happy and lit in jail, I'm your bail.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgot, ours will still be hot.
La la la, dig dig dig.
Come out. No, Mom, you can't cut my hair. There must be another way.
This is all Daddy's fault. He gave me the Hubba Bubba gum. 2 whole pieces. I can't help that I fell asleep. My hair will be way too short if you cut it. Can't you wash it out? Isn't there anything we can do? I don't want to lose all my hair.
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster. If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think again. Should learn to be happy. Never dreamed that a home could be dark and cold. I was told every day in my childhood, even when we grow old, home should be where. Learn to believe in. Try to find something good in this tragic place. Just in case I should stay here forever, held in this empty space. Oh, but that won't be.
Toto, what were we thinking coming back here to Kansas? Sure, the first few days back were great. Auntie Em and Uncle Henry by my side, bringing me soup, all hugs, kisses, and warmth. They were just so glad I was okay. But now that I'm fine, everything's gone back to the way it was. Auntie Em just acts like I'm in the way again. Yesterday, she told me to stop talking such nonsense or she'd call for the men in the white coats. I'm sure she was just trying to scare me, right, Toto? Why, that'd be more wicked than the Witch of the West, wouldn't it? No, Aunt Hiem loves me. She would never do that. What was that noise? If she hears me talking to you, she'd say you're just a dog and you don't understand me. But you do understand me, don't you, Toto? Oh, Toto, it's just you and I together in this world, and I know you feel like I do. You long for the Emerald City, don't you? You wonder how Scarecrow is getting on with his diploma. Has he gone on to graduate studies? Or the Tin Man with his heart, has he fallen in love? The Lion with his badge of courage, has he fought in any great battle? Oh, Toto, you understand me. That's why we have to get back to Oz. I tried to click my heels together yesterday, but my slippers here are too drab, so... There's a jewelry shop in town, and they have rubies. What we need to do is steal Uncle Henry's truck. He keeps a shotgun in the shed. We'll need that, too. Oh, it's not a crime, Toto, if no one gets hurt. We need those rubies, and I've got glue to attach them to my slippers. Before the police come, we'll be well on our way back to Oz. It's the perfect plan, right? Bark twice for yes.
I loved being an only child. So when Mom told me I was going to have a sibling in a few months, well, to be honest, it made me mad. Like, who does this? Who do they think they are? Pushing me out of my room, taking Mom and Dad to tension off me, and throwing our whole lives upside down. For the next few months, I was a total brat. I didn't do anything my mom asked. I was crying and kicking up a fuss every moment I could. But when I finally got to meet you, well, my whole world changed. It was a she for one, a little sister, and she looked just like me. I realized I wasn't losing anything, but instead, I was gaining a friend. That's why I'm so lucky to have you as a sister. So don't ever do anything like that again, okay?
Guitar, keeping to herself, Friday nights alone, with the records on her shelf, a waitress pouring ginger ale and coke, someone you ask out as a joke. I've been that girl who fades away, accepting what I've got, stuck in what I am and everything I'm not. I've only seen this tiny world I'm in, where I can only be what I've been. See a world beautiful and strange, spinning off somewhere, saying meet me there.
You're the oldest. They have to find a match for you before they find one for me.
And after her, one for me.
Oh, Yenta, Yenta, Yenta.
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches.
It could be someone wonderful.
Someone interesting. Match maker,
match maker, make me a match. Find me a fine, catch me a catch. Match maker, match maker, look through your book and make me a perfect match.
Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the MVP. will be looking at me, judging me. If I do one thing wrong, everyone's gonna notice and laugh at me. I'm gonna be so embarrassed. What if I suck? What if I'm horrible? What if people start throwing things, or worse, tell everyone about my performance and how much it sucked? I'm gonna be so nervous. People will always know me as a person who couldn't perform, the person who can't stand on that stage and nail it. I would use any excuse in the book not to have to perform. You know what? Maybe I can do this. I've practiced for hours. I know all of my words. I just have to stay calm and relaxed. The point is to just have fun, right? All right, I can do this.
Hi. I can't do this.
Little bubble with a flimsy kind of charm
and with very little trouble I could break her little arm.
Oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her? So obviously unusual. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a usual girl like me? Her cheeks are a pretty shade of pink, but not any pinker than a rose's. Skin may be delicate and soft, but not any softer than a dose's. Her neck is no whiter than a swan's. She's only as dainty as a daisy.
Stories all tell
somewhere beyond.